Good afternoon, welcome to the Shay under grey skies. This afternoon, Halifax looking to add to an impressive 5 wins in the last 6 matches, rattling up some big scores in the process, but also conceding points. And Halifax will have been working on the defence this week. Big win against the Leigh Centurions last week, who it looks like they may be facing in the end of season playoffs. Batley Bulldogs still harbouring hopes of taking that to last place in the top 6. Currently battling with Dewsbury and Sheffield for that honour, but it looks Sheffield's running to the end of the season, showing some impressive form, means that they might keep that position. Allride puts the ball down to the Batley 20, and the chase is good from Halifax. Mark Barlow into ultimately a four-man tackle. Little ground made so far. Gary Thornton having problems with Johnny Simpson, Martin McLaughlin and Luke Menzies all missing injured. Gives a chance to some of the fringe players.
This is a team change announcement for Batley Bulldogs. Tim Spears will now appear at number 11 and number 12 will be Tommy Gallagher.
Nothing spectacular in the early exchanges as Royston runs it back. Martin Hall making changes to the Halifax side from last week. Paul Smith gets the ball one-handed away to Gibson. Gibson steps inside. One attempted tackle caught by Tim Spears just outside the 20. Rested last week, Damien Gibson. And the first touch of the ball having immediate impact by taking it 30 metres upfield and potentially setting up the position. Lard has knocked off balance as he tried to go through the gap. Paul Southern, route one up the middle, offloads in the tackle. Sam Ho fires it wide to Paul Smith. A quick offload to Haley. Haley returns the pass to Paul Smith, and Smith put down 2 metres away on the last tackle. Penkovic off the outside of the foot, looking to put pressure on the Batley defence. Halifax chased down the fullback Jamie Stokes and forced the dropout. Looking to repeat the 58-8 win that they had at Mount Pleasant earlier in the season. Shad Royston at fullback this afternoon for Halifax. Damien Gibson returning after resting last week. James Haley returning after missing several months with a dislocated knee. Richard Varkoulis and Lee Greenwood, the other 3 quarters. Lee Greenwood continues to partner, Graham Holroyd continues to partner Sean Penkovic at halfback. Paul Southern, Sam Ho, David Rennes, David Larder, Damien Ball, Paul Smith, the forwards. Holroyd fires the ball out wide and Varkoulis is caught by 2. Tried to wrestle him towards that touchline. Halifax piling on the pressure. Larder, great tackle by Andy Jarrett on David Rennes, firing out of the line. Paul Southern to Penkovic. Penkovic looks for support and finds Paul Smith, but Smith just unable to get the offload away before being covered by 3 defenders. Last tackle again, Penkovic fires it out. Gibson unable to get the ball, a bullet of a pass. Penkovic trying to get it out wide, not really looking at the direction. Ball goes harmlessly into touch. Batley will get the opportunity to bring the ball away from their own line again. Jamie Stokes at fullback for them this afternoon. Ashley Lindsay, Craig Farrell, Mark Barlow and former Halifax man Ollie Marnes. In the 3 quarters, Richard Colley is at standoff with Francis Maloney at scrum half, recently signed from Dewsbury. Batley will be expecting a lot from Maloney. He's been about for a long time, lots of experience. Andy Jarrett, Chris Lythe and Luke Stenson are the front row. Tommy Gallagher on loan from Hull KR, playing potentially his last game this afternoon before returning to Humberside. Tim Spears at 12, Lee Patterson at 13, Mark Tookey, Chris Langley, Jack Watson and Anthony Thewlis are the replacements. Halifax get the ball from the first knock on. Penkovic looks for a gap and Stokes brings him down. Damien Ball drives the ball up 5 metres away from the Batley line. Penkovic to Southern, fires it to Holroyd. Short ball to Larder, running the angles back in. Straight into the tacklers, Holroyd to Southern. We won't get the option of the offload this time. Gallagher all over the Halifax prop. Damien Ball trying to step, unloads to Penkovic. Penkovic running out of options but manages to get the ball away to Southern. Southern fires a long pass to Varkoulis. And Varkoulis is again mobbed by three on that far side. Last tackle again. Batley line remains intact as Holroyd puts the crossfield kick in. Mounds is underneath it. But Batley still under pressure to bring the ball away from their own line. Barlow trying to do that into the tackle of Haley and Wrench. James Haley making a successful return through the academy side in the last 3 or 4 weeks. It looked as though his season might be over when he dislocated his knee. But a remarkable recovery. Tim Hartley also on the way back. Got through 40 minutes successfully on Thursday night in another big Alliance victory. Gibson feels the kick and looks for the pass to Royston. Eventually almost running into him, takes the tackle on the 40 metre line. Royston, a former Batley player, for his stint with Doncaster. But Batley penalised for the offside. And Graham Allroyd will put Batley back where they've been for the opening 10 minutes of this first half, and that's in their own half of the field. Damien Ball takes the pass from Sam Hoare, drives the ball up about 12 metres. Sam Hoare looking for the quick play, gets it to Paul Smith, playing at 13 in the absence of Phil Joseph, who's took a bit of a knock on the knee. Penkovic rips open the Batley defence there, feeds Gibson, and Gibson in for what's probably his easiest try of the season. Good play from Penkovic, not a hand laid on him, drew the defence. Nobody went for the tackle, but it left the space out wide for Damien Gibson to go over for the first try of the afternoon. And Gibson now has 11 for the season. Well, I suppose it was inevitable really that the line was going to break. Batley have been pushed back and kept in their own half of the field. And Halifax have had a lot of possession, and that possession finally turned into points, and a great kick from Holroyd from the touchline. Sails over, no problem. Halifax 6, Batley Bulldog 0. Maloney drills the ball, keeping it low. Penkovic using the feet. It's a slippery surface. Been some rain earlier. Well, it's not that cold. I don't think the field has fully dried from the earlier showers. Wrens takes it to the 20 metre line. Sam Hoare fields inside to Larder. Larder stopped by Patterson and Jarrett as Damien Ball opens up an opportunity but goes down before the ball can be offloaded to one of his teammates. Sam Hart gets to halfway, wants to get up for the quick play of the ball. It's the last tackle. Penkovic feeds it out to Holroyd, and Holroyd putting the pressure on Lindsay on that far side. And Lindsay will have to run it back almost through the gap. Holroyd and Varkoulis doing enough to stop the centre. Jamie Stokes trying to inject some pace, a former winger from Featherston. Luke Stenson stopped by a wall of blue and white shirts. Batley go to the right hand side, but Craig Farrell there, a victim of the slippery ground as he went down before he'd even reached the tackle, onto his knees. Last tackle signal, and Maloney will put the ball deep into Halifax territory. Royston, I think, thought that might have travelled over the line, but it stood up, so the fullbacks had to run it back. Almost to the 20. Greenwood going across the defence, and then thought he'd seen a bit of a gap. Patterson, the tackler. Gibson doing the work for his forwards. Sam Hart looked for support, but only succeeded in dropping the ball. And Richard Collett gives Batley the first set of six inside the Halifax half. And the referee gives the penalty for a high tackle. And Maloney punishes Halifax with a good kick, which puts Batley on the 10 metre line. And a first opportunity to put points on. Chris Lyde feeds Spears, and Spears stopped by Penkovic and Haley. Lyde gets it to Stenson, former Leeds Rhino. He goes back into Penkovic, same tackler. Chris Lyde drops the shoulder. There wasn't a gap there. Paul Southern, the tackler. Patterson to Maloney. Maloney has Craig Farrell in support, but he can't get through. Maloney again orchestrating, puts the kick in, and Halifax will watch it run dead. So the defence sticking to the task on that occasion for Halifax. And Gibson, the recipient of some rough treatment there, although the penalty will be for holding down. Sam Hawk gets to halfway, this time keeps hold of possession. Damien Ball to Holroyd. Royston linking up. Ladder was ambling in support rather than attempting to run onto the ball. Royston takes it up to the 40. Holroyd continues to the left-hand side, where Varkoulis is wrapped up again by a gang tackle, keeping a close eye on the big centre of Batley. Penkovic fires it out wide, and Marnes is round Gibson, and he gets the ball inside, so Halifax will get possession, because Mark Barlow couldn't pick it up, but Penkovic still intent on keeping the ball alive as Sam Hoare takes the direct route towards the line and gets to the 20. Paul Southern to Damien Ball. And Batley on the back foot, right back to their own try line. Courtesy of Barlow, not able to take the pass. Southern looking around for the option of an offload from the tackle. Sam Hoare powering towards the line from acting half, stopped inches away. Southern fires it out to Holroyd, who gets it up on the bounce. Holroyd kicks off the side of the foot. Halifax will put the pressure on and force another drop out under the post. Royston following up Holroyd's kick perfectly there. Lindsay caught in goal to force a second drop out under the post. I think Halifax will be happy with that, because it could have been Batley's first score if Barlow had managed to take that ball from Marnes. Risky pass from Penkovic, snapped up by the winger. Penkovic keeps the ball to himself this time. Jarrett wraps him up, puts him to ground. Halifax about 11 metres away from the line as Wrench gets the return off Damien Ball, and Damien Ball tries to duck under the two tacklers. Sam Hoare 5 metres out, back to that left hand side again. Larder the run round with Holroyd. Holroyd out to Greenwood, and Greenwood in at the corner. Well, he had a shaky start last week, did Lee Greenwood, when Lee scored the first try off the high kick, but he made amends throughout the game, being involved in three or four of Halifax's tries, and on the end of a move there involving the run round with Larder and Holroyd, and Greenwood squeezing in at the corner, the club's top try scorer with now 21 for the season. Extends the lead, moves Halifax into double figures. Halifax 10, Batley Bulldogs 0.
Try score for Halifax, sponsored by Steve Shortry. Number 5, Lee Greenwood.
Holroyd from the touchline again. Couldn't manage to make the target this time. So it remains 10-0. And Halifax managing to force the drop out again and get the possession and put the pressure on. And Maloney again, keeping the kick low. Penkovic gives it to Gibson, and there was a high tackle. Well, it looked high the last time Gibson took the ball up. That took it just on the field. Gives away the penalty. And there's all over Damien Ball layer. Southern shouts forward pass. Well, it didn't look like it. There was a few shouts of a forward. Referee Gareth Hewer deciding to give Batley the benefit of the doubt. They'll get the scrum. Patterson has gone to scrum half. Has gone to loose forward. Maloney caught by Varkul. It's almost taking the ball there, but knocking it on. We've Batley possession at the scrum again. Well, Maloney not as fleet-footed as he used to be. No doubt he still has the handling and the kicking skills. Patterson up to the Halifax 40. Stokes to Marnes. And Marnes makes about 8 metres before being stopped. Patterson gives quick service to Tim Spears. But the defence is equally as quick onto the Bulldog second rower. Chris Lythe to Patterson. Maloney has runners in Gallagher, but Gallagher stopped 10 metres out. Stenson driving towards the line. Takes three defenders to stop him. Batley have a few men stacked over here. They've also got Farrell charging onto the ball. And the referee has denied Batley the try, saying that was Farrell was held up. Well, he came onto that like an express, did Craig Farrell. Thinks he's still got possession, but it was a last tackle. So it's a turnover. That's why the referee stood in the Batley line, not too keen to surrender possession. And then perhaps a little bit offside there as Greenwood ran the ball up. Wrench flattened by three. It's Batley trying to step up the pace a little bit in defence. And Southern dragging himself forward towards that 40 metre line. And that's Chris Lythe all over him. Sam Ho to Penkovic. Penkovic looked for support. That's the third one that's gone to ground off Penkovic. Well, they played in glorious conditions last week, but with a slippy ball and a slippy ground, it's not an afternoon for the fancy stuff. And another Penkovic pass goes to ground.
Substitution for Halifax
will be tested in defence again.
Number 17, Frank Wattini, for number 10, Dave Wrench.
Frank Wattini on for Dave Wrench, and Aaron Trinder soon to be introduced as well as he waits his turn to come on. Tui gets the ball away. Halifax are offside, says the referee. Andy Jarrett driving towards the post. Chris Lythe fires it out to Maloney. Maloney with the runners, but Larder with support from Greenwood. And now Greenwood's given the ball to run back on the inside, turning the defence inside out. Has the pace on the outside. Greenwood looking for a double. Stokes has pace, but he won't get to him. Greenwood will get the ball down. Well, Dave Larder made Lee Greenwood do a bit of extra work there. He had to come inside. He was trying to draw the defence to him was Larder. A bit non-committed, and when they did, Greenwood was on his way back on the inside and then went back out towards the touchline. Farrell's despairing dive got nowhere near. Stokes is a former winger, chased down Greenwood. By the time he got to him, Greenwood had to slide over the line, put the ball down. A double for the winger. A third try for Halifax. And a lead of Halifax 14, Batley Bulldogs 0. And Greenwood leaving Holroyd. Another kick. Close to that far touch line. Well, has had one practice as he found the marker this time. Again, it's sailed across the front of the post. It stays at 14 points to nil. Aaron Trinder on for Paul Southern. Harry Thornton also making changes as Maloney goes for the short kick. Haley picks it up off the ground. Chase from Patterson and Tuwe. Trinder charges the ball up and he's still going forward despite the attention of three defenders. And now Frank Wattini drives the ball up. Well, Trinder and Wattini running the ball up will take a bit out of the Batley defence, but they're not keen to get up and let Halifax have the quick play of the ball. Holroyd pops it up for Royston, and Royston takes a clatter in. Larder to Varkoulis, and again Varkoulis struggling against the defence. Langley the first man in.
Number 15,
reinforcements there quickly. Penkovic off the side of the foot, looking to put the ball behind the Batley line again. And Batley will be forced once again to drop out. That's the third time. Seems to be becoming quite a trademark for Halifax. Forcing the opposition to drop out from behind the post, or beneath the post. So Maloney's kick will reach Penkovic just inside halfway, and Trinder will take it back 20 metres. And Martini will look to do the same. And almost does as well. He's made another probably 12 or 13. Sam Hoare feeds Holroyd back on the inside. He's Royston. And Royston almost through. Again, the tackle looked to be around the neck. Penkovic turned it inside to Damien Ball, but Ball has nowhere to go. Defence on him as soon as he took the ball. Sam Hoare has Wattini running. Reached out but couldn't get to the line. Last tackle. Damien Ball fires it away to Holroyd, and Holroyd. An uncharacteristic mistake. Maloney flew out of the blocks there, and he's quick to try and get the ball back into play. But Gareth Hugh are waiting while Halifax are back onside for allowing play to continue. Approaching the half hour mark, 14 points to nil. Not as easy as it was against Lee last week. But the defensive effort is probably as much as Martin Hall could expect. Batley, very few visits into the Halifax half of the field. I think it's only the third of the first half. But forcing the dropout, making the tackles. Toohey kicks for Marnes to chase, and Royston will pick it up, and Marnes is left with nothing as Royston cuts loose with a ball back on the counter-attack, gets over the 20-metre line, and there's a quick play as well. Penkovic slips one tackle, gets to 5 metres from halfway. Frank Wattini taking the ball from a standing start, takes it over halfway into a three-man tackle. Damien Ball moves into acting half as Holroyd puts Greenwood on a chase again. Lindsay will go back, and Lindsay is going to be caught behind his line again, and Halifax will produce another great run, which will mean Batley dropping out from under the post for the fourth time. Lindsay doing his best to get out of trouble, but
number 14, Ian Watson, for number 9, Sam Hoare.
He was never going to get the ball back into the field of play. Gareth Hugh speaking with his touch judge. And Ollie Marnes being pulled out by the referee, I think, for the attempted trip on Shad Royston at the other end of the field.
Well, we'd sort of made a 30-yard break, didn't we, from it, so we needed a quick play of
ball. Yeah. So Marnes warned for the attempted trip on Royston, who will be underneath the kick and give it to Trinder. Trinder charges a ball back up into the Batley defence, stopped by three. Wattini over the 20. Halifax looking for 4 points before the half time break. Watson, who replaced Sam Hoare, will get clattered. What a good tackle from Tim Spears and Lee Patterson. Trinder throws the dummy 5 metres away. Penkovic to Watson. Watson goes again on his own. tries to get the arm free. Last tackle, Penkovic buries his way through, but will he get the ball down? No, the Batley defence force him back. But the pressure not off, because Batley, once again, will have to run the ball away from their own line. And Marnes caught by Watson and Gibson, trying the outside line. Patterson from acting half. Damien Ball leaves the field to be replaced by Mark Roberts, who'll get one of his rare games in the second row by the look of it. Gibson covering the ball, Royston picks it up. Wanted Gibson to have a run, and Gibson said, "You'll go on your own. I've just run all the way back to the ball," and Royston goes in field. Haley stopped, ball comes loose. Referee at the touch to the other side said it was a knock on.
Substitution for Halifax, sponsored by Morgan Search UK, number 12, Damien Ball.
And Tuchin's on the far side, looking a bit stunned there when the when Gareth Hewer asked him what had happened. Maloney caught by Royston. Now it's Batley's turn to look for points before the half-time break. Marnes almost getting through. Smith and Royston doing the tackling. Jack Watson stopped 3 metres away. Maloney has runners, with the door shut on Tommy Gallagher. By Wattini and Penkovic. Chances now, but again, Thewlis this time snubbed out on the last tackle. It'll go back to Maloney for the kick. And Maloney has got a better kick in this time, but Gibson the first to it. Well, Halifax supporters not agreeing. They think Gibson was in the field of play when he took the ball, but he finished up behind the line. And there may have been a case for being making the attempt to tackle in the air there, I'm not so sure. Allright, a long kick, Marnes underneath, gives it inside to Watson. And Watson takes it to the 14 of the tackle of Roberts and Smith. Chris Lyde feeds Thewlis. Frank Wattini and Trinder stopping the progress of the Batley replacement. To on the run round with Spears, turning back inside Lyde. Out to the right hand side, Patterson will find Maloney, and Maloney will lose possession in trying to keep the ball alive as Larder then loses possession. It's picked up by Stokes, and a chance for Batley to attack the line, but Lindsay wriggling out of the first two tackles, taking the ball back to within 5 metres, and that play, the ball looked to be far too quick, but it's paid dividends, and Chris Langley has gone in at the corner for Batley's first try on around 35 minutes. Well, Halifax were on the breakaway, Larder was looking for support, there was nobody there. And he didn't have hold of the ball tightly enough, it came loose. Batley went on the counter-attack with Stokes. And Langley strolled over in the corner. Most of the Halifax side had stopped expecting something from the referee. Batley played to the whistle, they've got the first 4 points. It's Halifax 14, Batley Bulldogs 4. And Maloney's kick rattles back off the post, much to the joy of the Halifax supporters.
High scorer for Batley, number 15, Chris Langley.
So Batley back in the match. More by luck than management. Anyway, that's for sure. Halifax had done the tackling, dislodged the possession. And Batley managed to get it back. Good tackle from Watson. Quickly followed up by Smith on the Batley 20. And Roberts it is again with Smith. Halting that run after about 3 metres. Lythe feeds it to Jack Watson. Chris Lythe back to Maloney, who will try and successfully get a 40-20. Greenwood saw what was happening but was too slow to react to get back for the kick. It was a huge kick by Maloney. And this has given the Bulldogs a glorious opportunity before half-time to pull themselves right back into this game. Tua sets the ball on his own. And Royston around the legs, claiming the penalty. Maloney, the old stager, going for the try. And he's not that far off neither. He just stops out of the line by the Halifax defence. Stokes fires the pass away. Lythe takes it on the bounce. And then falls to the tackle of Penkovic. All hands to the pump for Halifax as... that must have been a yard forward. Oh, dearie me, he's not seen that one. And Halifax almost getting caught from acting half there. The gap that was there, but Lythe just couldn't get through it. Now back to Maloney. Is this another kick? It is. And Gibson is behind his own line this time. And wrestling with Marnes. Halifax looking for the quick play with Penkovic. Gibson wanted to get into the action and get back to the play of the ball, but Penkovic took it on his own and made 10. Paul Smith will make another 10. Watson to Roberts. Stopped by Farrell. Trinder to Watine. Halifax just getting over the 40. Larder. Taken by Chris Lythe on the last tackle, 22 metres out. Back to Watson. And that one has put Marnes under all sorts of pressure. But Batley come up with the possession with Patterson. Now Marnes invited to run the ball out into the significant frame of Watine. Stokes trying to help out the forwards, takes the ball up to the 20. And Batley lose it in an effort to keep it alive. Varkoulis, for once, slips the net of the first tackle and the second. But then he's stopped by Tua. And Tim Spears. Watine gets it to Penkovic. And Penkovic stuck then because Royston almost fell over him. Lindsay tries to go around the outside, but Greenwood wraps him up after Larder missed him at the first attempt. Batley back up to the 40, looking for the quick play of the ball. The quick play of the ball takes him up to halfway. Spears takes it over the 40. Patterson gets it away to Stokes, and Stokes has support from Maloney. And Maloney's away from three. Unfortunately, the pass bounced off the head of the hooker, Chris Lizer, went forward. Halifax were looking frail then. It was Maloney, the old campaigner, who cut the Halifax defence apart. The final pass letting him down. The ball bouncing forward off the head of the hooker. Roberts comes up from loose forward. Haley taking the ball up. There's shouts that the Batley players are in an offside position. They're certainly struggling to make it square at the play the ball. Martini takes the pass off Penkovic. Looked as though I was expecting Penkovic to go for the return then, but the pass didn't come. And Penkovic puts it off the outside of his boot, and Greenwood could benefit from this, but Penkovic has made the support, and Varkoulis for the first time in the match without a marker and without anybody watching him closely, Varkoulis strides over. Greenwood somehow managing to get the ball back. Penkovic looked like he might have scored, but the Batley defence scrambling, and the scrum half feeds Varkoulis, who for once was unmarked, and it went over for the fourth try of the first half. Going to try to settle the nerves a little bit. Halifax 18, Batley Bulldogs 4. And the last action of this first half will be Holroyd's kick. And it's another attempt from Holroyd from far out of the other side of the field. Well, it's getting closer. It comes back off the post. And it's time for half time with Halifax. Not as spectacular as they were last week, but conditions proving a little bit difficult, and Halifax losing possession on several occasions. But four tries from Gibson, two from Greenwood, one from Varkoulis. Just the one conversion from Graham Holroyd against the try for Langley for Batley, which was a touch fortuitous after the possession was lost in the middle of the field. Half-time score, Halifax 18, Batley Bulldogs 4. Batley almost running into him, takes the tackle on the 40-metre line. Royston, a former Batley player. For his stint with Doncaster, but Batley penalised for the offside. And Graham Holroyd will put Batley back where they've been for the opening 10 minutes of this first half, and that's in their own half of the field. Damien Ball takes the pass from Sam Hoare, drives the ball up about 12 metres. Sam Hoare looking for the quick play, gets it to Paul Smith, playing at 13 in the absence of Phil Joseph, who's took a bit of a knock on the knee. Penkovic rips open the Batley defence there, feeds Gibson, and Gibson in for what's probably his easiest try of the season. Good play from Penkovic, not a hand laid on him, drew the defence. Nobody went for the tackle, but it left the space out wide for Damien Gibson to go over for the first try of the afternoon. And Gibson now has 11 for the season. Well, I suppose it was inevitable, really, that the line was going to break. Batley have been pushed back and kept in their own half of the field. And Halifax have had a lot of possession, and that possession finally turned into points, and a great kick from Holroyd from the touchline. Sails over, no problem. Halifax 6, Batley Bulldog 0.
Successful conversion for Halifax, sponsored by Halifax Independent Supporters Trust. Number 6, Graham Holroyd.
Maloney drills the ball, keeping it low. Penkovic using the feet. It's a slippery surface. Been some rain earlier. Well, it's not that cold. I don't think the field has fully dried from the earlier showers. Rens takes it to the 20 metre line. Sam Hofield's inside to Larder. Larder stopped by Patterson and Jarrett as Damien Ball opens up an opportunity but goes down before the ball can be offloaded to one of his teammates. Sam Hart gets to halfway. Wants to get up for the quick play of the ball. It's the last tackle. Penkovic feeds it out to Holroyd, and Holroyd putting the pressure on Lindsay on that far side. And Lindsay will have to run it back almost through the gap. Holroyd and Varkul is doing enough to stop the centre. Jamie Stokes trying to inject some pace, a former winger from Featherston. Luke Stenson stopped by a wall of blue and white shirts. Batley go to the right hand side, but Craig Farrell there, a victim of the slippery ground as he went down before he'd even reached the tackle, onto his knees. Last tackle signal, and Maloney will put the ball deep into Halifax territory. Royston, I think, thought that might have travelled over the line, but it stood up, so the fullbacks had to run it back. Almost to the 20. Greenwood going across the defence and then thought he'd seen a bit of a gap. Patterson, the tackler. Gibson doing the work for his forwards. Sam Hoare looked for support, but only succeeded in dropping the ball. And Richard Collett gives Batley the first set of six inside the Halifax half. And the referee gives the penalty for a high tackle. And Maloney punishes Halifax with a good kick, which puts Batley on the 10 metre line. And a first opportunity to put points on. Chris Lyde feeds Spears, and Spears stopped by Penkovic and Haley. Lyde gets it to Stenson, former Leeds Rhino. He goes back into Penkovic, same tackler. Chris Lyde drops the shoulder. There wasn't a gap there. Paul Southern, the tackler. Patterson to Maloney. Maloney has Craig Farrell in support, but he can't get through. Maloney again orchestrating, puts the kick in, and Halifax will watch it run dead. So the defence sticking to the task on that occasion for Halifax. And Gibson, the recipient of some rough treatment there, although the penalty will be for holding down. Sam Hawke gets to halfway, this time keeps hold of possession. Damien Ball to Holroyd. Royston linking up. Larder was ambling in support rather than attempting to run onto the ball. Royston takes it up to the 40. Holroyd continues to the left-hand side, where Varkulis is wrapped up again by a gang tackle, keeping a close eye on the big centre of Batley. Penkovic fires it out wide, and Marnes is round Gibson, and he gets the ball inside, so Halifax will get possession because Mark Barlow couldn't pick it up. But Penkovic still intent on keeping the ball alive as Sam Hoare takes the direct route towards the line and gets to the 20. Paul Southern to Damien Ball. And Batley on the back foot, right back to their own try line. courtesy of Barlow, not able to take the pass. Southern looking around for the option of an offload from the tackle. Sam Hoare powering towards the line from acting half, stopped inches away. Southern fires it out to Holroyd, who gets it up on the bounce. Holroyd kicks off the side of the foot. Halifax will put the pressure on and force another drop out under the post. Royston following up Holroyd's kick perfectly there. Lindsay caught in goal to force a second drop out under the post. I think Halifax will be happy with that, because it could have been Batley's first score if Barlow had managed to take that ball from Marnes. Risky pass from Penkovic, snapped up by the winger. Penkovic keeps the ball to himself this time. Jarrett wraps him up, puts him to ground. Halifax about 11 metres away from the line as Wrench gets the return off Damien Ball, and Damien Ball tries to duck under the two tacklers. Sam Hoare 5 metres out, back to that left hand side again. Larder the run round with Holroyd. Holroyd out to Greenwood, and Greenwood in at the corner. Well, he had a shaky start last week, did Lee Greenwood, when Lee scored the first try off the high kick, but he made amends throughout the game, being involved in three or four of Halifax's tries. And on the end of a move there involving the run round with Larder and Holroyd, and Greenwood squeezing in at the corner. The club's top try scorer with now 21 for the season, extends the lead, moves Halifax into double figures. Halifax 10, Batley Bulldogs 0.
Try score for Halifax, sponsored by Steve Shortry. Number 5, Lee Greenwood.
Holroyd from the touchline again. Couldn't make the target this time. So it remains 10-0. And Halifax managing to force the drop out again and get the possession and put the pressure on. And Maloney again, keeping the kick low. Penkovic gives it to Gibson, and there was a high tackle. Well, it looked high the last time Gibson took the ball up. That took it just on the field. Gives away the penalty.
6, Richard Colley.
And there's all over Damien Ball layer. Southern shouts forward pass. Well, it didn't look like it. There was a few shouts of a forward. Referee Gareth Hewer deciding to give Batley the benefit of the doubt. They'll get the scrum. Patterson has gone to scrum half, to a, has gone to loose forward. Maloney caught by Varkoulis, almost taking the ball there but knocking it on. We've got Batley possession at the scrum again. Well, Maloney not as fleet footed as he used to be. No doubt he still has the handling and the kicking skills. Patterson up to the Halifax 40. Stokes to Marnes. And Marnes makes about 8 metres before being stopped. Patterson gives quick service to Tim Spears. But the defence is equally as quick onto the Bulldog second rower. Chris Lythe to Patterson. Maloney has runners in Gallagher, but Gallagher stopped 10 metres out. Stenson driving towards the line. Takes three defenders to stop him. Batley have a few men stacked over here. They've also got Farrell charging onto the ball. And the referee has denied Batley the try, saying that was Farrell was held up. Well, he came onto that like an express, did Craig Farrell. Thinks he's still got possession, but it was a last tackle. So it's a turnover. That's why the referee stood in the Batley line, not too keen to surrender possession. And then perhaps a little bit offside there as Greenwood ran the ball up. Wrench flattened by three. It's Batley trying to step up the pace a little bit in defence. And Southern dragging himself forward towards that 40 metre line. And that's Chris Lythe all over him. Sam Hoare to Penkovic. Penkovic looked for support. That's the third one that's gone to ground off Penkovic. Only played in glorious conditions last week, but with a slippy ball and a slippy ground, it's not an afternoon for the fancy stuff. And another Penkovic pass goes to ground.
Substitution for Halifax.
Halifax will be tested in defence again.
Number 17, Frank Wittini, for number 10, Dave Wrench.
Frank Wittini on for Dave Wrench, and Aaron Trinder soon to be introduced as well as he waits his turn to come on. Tui gets the ball away. Halifax are offside, says the referee. Andy Jarrett driving towards the post. Chris Lythe fires it out to Maloney. Maloney with the runners, but Larder with support from Greenwood. And now Greenwood's given the ball to run back on the inside, turning the defence inside out. Has the pace on the outside. Greenwood looking for a double. Stokes has pace, but he won't get to him. Greenwood will get the ball down. Well, Dave Larder made Lee Greenwood do a bit of extra work there. He had to come inside. He was trying to draw the defence to him was Larder. A bit non-committed, and when they did, Greenwood was on his way back on the inside and then went back out towards the touchline. Farrell's despairing dive got nowhere near. Stokes as a former winger chased down Greenwood. By the time he'd got to him, Greenwood had to slide over the line, put the ball down. A double for the winger. A third try for Halifax, and a lead of Halifax 14, Batley Bulldogs 0. And Greenwood leaving Holroyd. Another kick close to that far touch line. Well, has had one practice as he found the marker this time. Again, it's sailed across the front of the post. It stays at 14 points to nil. Aaron Trinder on for Paul Southern. Harry Thornton also making changes as Maloney goes for the short kick. Haley picks it up off the ground. chase from Patterson and Tuwek. Trinder charges the ball up and he's still going forward despite the attention of three defenders. And now Frank Wattini drives the ball up. And Trinder and Wattini running the ball up will take a bit out of the Batley defence, but they're not keen to get up and let Halifax have the quick play of the ball. Holroyd pops it up for Royston. And Royston takes a clatter in. Larder to Varkoulis. And again, Varkoulis struggling against the defence. Langley the first man in. Reinforcements there quickly. Penkovic off the side of the foot. Looking to put the ball behind the Batley line again. And Batley will be forced once again to drop out. That's the third time. Seems to be becoming quite a trademark for Halifax. Forcing the opposition to drop out from behind the post, or beneath the post. So Maloney's kick will reach Penkovic just inside halfway. And Trinder will take it back 20 metres. And Martini will look to do the same. And almost does as well. He's made another probably 12 or 13. Sam Hoare feeds Holroyd back on the inside. He's Royston. And Royston almost through. Again, the tackle looked to be around the neck. Penkovic turned it inside to Damien Ball, but Ball has nowhere to go. Defence on him as soon as he took the ball. Sam Hoare has Wattini running. Reached out but couldn't get to the line. Last tackle. Damien Ball fires it away to Holroyd, and Holroyd. An uncharacteristic mistake. Maloney flew out of the blocks there and he's quick to try and get the ball back into play. But Gareth Hugh are waiting while Halifax are back onside for allowing the play to continue. Approaching the half hour mark, 14 points to nil. Not as easy as it was against Lee last week. But the defensive effort is probably as much as Martin Hall could expect. Batley, very few visits into the Halifax half of the field. I think it's only the third of the first half. But forcing the dropout and making the tackles. Toohey kicks for Marnes to chase, and Royston will pick it up. And Marnes is left with nothing as Royston cuts loose with a ball back on the counter-attack, gets over the 20-metre line, and there's a quick play as well. Penkovic slips one tackle, gets to 5 metres from halfway. Frank Wattini taking the ball from a standing start, takes it over halfway into a three-man tackle. Damien Ball moves into acting half as Holroyd puts Greenwood on a chase again. Lindsay will go back, and Lindsay is going to be caught behind his line again, and Halifax will produce another great run, which will mean Batley dropping out from under the post for the fourth time. Lindsay doing his best to get out of trouble, but
number 14, Ian Watson, for number 9, Sam Hoare.
He was never going to get the ball back into the field of play. Gareth Hewer speaking with his touch judge. And Ollie Marnes being pulled out by the referee, I think, for the attempted trip on Shad Royston at the other end of the field.
Well, we'd sort of made a 30-yard break, didn't we, from it, so we needed a quick play of
the ball. So Marnes warned for the attempted trip on Royston. who will be underneath the kick and give it to Trinder. Trinder charges a ball back up into the Batley defence, stopped by three. Martini over the 20. Halifax looking for 4 points before the half time break. Watson, who replaced Sam Hoare, will get clattered. What a good tackle from Tim Spears and Lee Patterson. Trinder throws the dummy 5 metres away. Penkovic to Watson. Watson goes again on his own. Tries to get the arm free. Last tackle. Penkovic burrs his way through, but will he get the ball down? No, the Batley defence forcing back. But the pressure not off, because Batley, once again, will have to run the ball away from their own line. And Marnes caught by Watson and Gibson, trying the outside line. Patterson from acting half. Damien Ball leaves the field to be replaced by Mark Roberts, who'll get one of his rare games in the second row by the look of it. Gibson covering the ball. Royston picks it up. Wanted Gibson to have a run, and Gibson said, "You'll go on your own. I've just run all the way back to the ball," and Royston goes in field. Haley stopped. Ball comes loose. Referee at the touchdown to the other side said it was a knock on. Tucci's on the far side, looking a bit stunned there when Gareth Hewer asked him what had happened. Maloney caught by Royston. Now it's Batley's turn to look for points before the half-time break. Marnes almost getting through. Smith and Royston doing the tackling. Jack Watson stopped 3 metres away. Maloney has runners, but the door shut on Tommy Gallagher by Wattini and Penkovic. Chances now, but again Thewlis this time snubbed out on the last tackle. It'll go back to Maloney for the kick, and Maloney has got a better kick in this time, but Gibson the first to it. Well, Halifax supporters not agreeing. They think Gibson was in the field of play when he took the ball, but he finished up behind the line. And there may have been a case for being making the attempt to tackle in the air there, I'm not so sure. Holroyd's a long kick, Marnes underneath, gives it inside to Watson. And Watson takes it to the 14 of the tackle of Roberts and Smith. Chris Lyth feeds Thewlis. Martini and Trinder stopping the progress of the Batley replacement. So we're on the run round with Spears, turning back inside Lyth. Out to the right-hand side, Patterson will find Maloney, and Maloney will lose possession in trying to keep the ball alive as Larder then loses possession. It's picked up by Stokes, and a chance for Batley to attack the line, but Lindsay wriggling out of the first two tackles, taking the ball back to within 5 metres, and that play, the ball looked to be far too quick, but it's paid dividends, and Chris Langley has gone in at the corner for Batley's first try on around 35 minutes. Well, Halifax were on the breakaway. Larder was looking for support. There was nobody there. And he didn't have hold of the ball tightly enough. It came loose. Batley went on the counter-attack with Stokes. And Langley strolled over in the corner. Most Halifax side had stopped expecting something from the referee. Batley play to the whistle. They've got the first 4 points. It's Halifax 14, Batley Bulldogs 4. And Maloney's kick rattles back off the post, much to the joy of the Halifax supporters.
High score for Patrick, number 15, Chris Langley.
So Batley back in the match. More by luck than management, anyway, that's for sure. Halifax had done the tackling, dislodged the possession. And Batley managed to get it back, good tackle from Watson. Quickly followed up by Smith on the Batley 20. And Roberts, it is again with Smith halting that run after about 3 metres. Blythe feeds it to Jack Watson. Three slide back to Maloney, who will try and successfully get a 40-20. Greenwood saw what was happening but was too slow to react to get back for the kick. It was a huge kick by Maloney. And this has given the Bulldogs a glorious opportunity before half time to pull herself right back into this game. Tue takes the ball on his own. And Royston around the legs, claiming the penalty. Maloney, the old stager, going for the try. And he's not that far off neither, he just stops out of the line by the Halifax defence. Stokes fires the pass away, Lythe takes it on the bounce. And then falls to the tackle of Penkovic. All hands to the pump for Halifax as, oh, that must have been a yard forward. Oh dearie me, he's not seen that one. And Halifax almost getting caught from acting half there. The gap that was there, but Lythe just couldn't get through it. Now back to Maloney. Is this another kick? It is. And Gibson is behind his own line this time. And wrestling with Marnes. Halifax looking for the quick play with Penkovic. Gibson wanted to get into the action and get back to the play of the ball, but Penkovic took it on his own and made 10. Paul Smith will make another 10. Watson to Roberts. Stopped by Farrell. Trinder to Watine. Halifax just getting over the fortet. Larder taken by Chris Lythe on the last tackle, 22 metres out. Back to Watson. And that one has put Marnes under all sorts of pressure. But Batley come up with the possession with Patterson. Now Marnes invited to run the ball out into the significant frame of Watine. Stokes trying to help out the forwards, takes the ball up to the 20. And Batley lose it in an effort to keep it alive. Varkoulis, for once, slips the net of the first tackle and the second. But then he's stopped by Tue. And Tim Spears. Watine gets it to Penkovic. And Penkovic stuck then because Royston almost fell over him. Lindsay tries to go around the outside, but Greenwood wraps him up after Larder missed him at the first attempt. Batley back up to the 40, looking for the quick play of the ball. The quick play of the ball takes him up to halfway. Spears takes it over the 40. Patterson gets it away to Stokes, and Stokes has support from Maloney. And Maloney's away from three. Unfortunately, the pass bounced off the head of the hooker, Chris Lizer, went forward. Halifax were looking frail then. It was Maloney, the old campaigner, who cut the Halifax defence apart. The final pass letting him down. The ball bouncing forward off the head of the hooker. Roberts comes up from loose forward. Haley taking the ball up. This shouts that the Batley players are in an offside position. They're certainly struggling to make it square at the play of the ball. Martini takes the pass off Penkovic. Looked as though he was expecting Penkovic to go for the return then, but the pass didn't come. And Penkovic puts it off the outside of his boot, and Greenwood could benefit from this, but Penkovic has made the support, and Varkoulis for the first time in the match without a marker and without anybody watching him closely, Varkoulis strides over. Greenwood somehow managing to get the ball back. Penkovic looked like he might have scored, but the Batley defence scrambling, and the scrum half feeds Varkoulis, who for once was unmarked, and it went over for the fourth try of the first half. Going to try to settle the nerves a little bit. Halifax 18, Batley Bulldogs 4. And the last action of this first half will be Holroyd's kick.
TV match on Friday, I noticed.
And it's another attempt from Holroyd from far out of the other side of the field. Well, it's getting closer. It comes back off the post, and it's time for half time with Halifax. Not as spectacular as they were last week, but conditions proving a little bit difficult, and Halifax losing possession on several occasions. But four tries from Gibson, two from Greenwood, one from Barkoulis. Just the one conversion from Graham Holroyd against the try for Langley for Batley, which was a touch fortuitous after the possession was lost in the middle of the field. Half time score, Halifax 18, Batley Bulldogs 4. Mark Barlow couldn't pick it up, but Penkovic still intent on keeping the ball alive as Sam Hoare takes the direct route towards the line and gets to the 20. Paul Southern to Damien Ball. And Batley on the back foot, right back to their own try line. Courtesy of Barlow, not able to take the pass. Southern looking around for the option of an offload from the tackle. Sam Hoare powering towards the line from acting half, stopped inches away. Southern fires it out to Holroyd, who gets it up on the bounce. Holroyd kicks off the side of the foot. Halifax will put the pressure on and force another drop out under the post. Royston following up Holroyd's kick perfectly there. Lindsay caught in goal to force a second drop out under the post. I think Halifax will be happy with that, because it could have been Batley's first score if Barlow had managed to take that ball from Marnes. Risky pass from Penkovic, snapped up by the winger. Penkovic keeps the ball to himself this time. Jarrett wraps him up, puts him to ground. Halifax about 11 metres away from the line as Wrench gets the return off Damien Ball, and Damien Ball tries to duck under the two tacklers. Sam Hoare 5 metres out, back to that left-hand side again. Larder the run round with Holroyd. Holroyd out to Greenwood, and Greenwood in at the corner. Well, he had a shaky start last week, did Lee Greenwood, when Lee scored the first try off the high kick, but he made amends throughout the game, being involved in three or four of Halifax's tries. And on the end of a move there involving the run round with Larder and Holroyd, and Greenwood squeezing in at the corner. The club's top try scorer with now 21 for the season. Extends the lead, moves Halifax into double figures. Halifax 10, Batley Bulldogs 0.
Try scorer for Halifax, sponsored by Steve Shotry. Number 5, Lee Greenwood.
Holroyd from the touchline again. Couldn't make the target this time. So it remains 10-0. And Halifax managing to force the drop out again and get the possession and put the pressure on. And Maloney again, keeping the kick low. Penkovic gives it to Gibson, and there was a high tackle. Well, it looked high the last time Gibson took the ball up. That took it just on the field. Gives away the penalty. And there's all over Damien Ball layer. Southern shouts forward pass. Well, it didn't look like it, but there was a few shouts of a forward. Referee Gareth Hewer deciding to give Batley the benefit of the doubt. They'll get the scrum. Patterson has gone to scrum half, to a has gone to loose forward. Maloney caught by Varkoulis, almost taking the ball there but knocking it on. We've got Batley possession at the scrum again. Well, Maloney not as fleet footed as he used to be. No doubt he still has the handling and the kicking skills. Patterson up to the Halifax 40. Stokes to Marnes. And Marnes makes about 8 metres before being stopped. Patterson gives quick service to Tim Spears. But the defence is equally as quick onto the Bulldog second rower. Chris Lythe to Patterson. Maloney has runners in Gallagher, but Gallagher stopped 10 metres out. Stenson driving towards the line. Takes three defenders to stop him. Batley have a few men stacked over here. They've also got Farrell charging onto the ball. And the referee has denied Batley the try, saying that was Farrell was held up. Well, he came onto that like an express, did Craig Farrell. Thinks he's still got possession, but it was a last tackle. So it's a turnover. That's why the referee stood in the Batley line, not too keen to surrender possession. And then perhaps a little bit offside there, as Greenwood ran the ball up. Wrench flattened by three. It's Batley trying to step up the pace a little bit in defence, and Southern dragging himself forward towards that 40 metre line. And as Chris Lythe all over him, Sam Hoare to Penkovic. Penkovic looked for support. That's the third one that's gone to ground off Penkovic. Only played in glorious conditions last week, but with a slippy ball and a slippy ground, it's not an afternoon for the fancy stuff. And another Penkovic pass goes to ground.
Substitution for Halifax.
Halifax will be tested in defence again.
Number 17, Frank Wattini, for number 10, Dave Wrench.
Frank Wattini on for Dave Wrench, and Aaron Trinder soon to be introduced as well as he waits his turn to come on. Tui gets the ball away. Halifax are offside, says the referee. Andy Jarrett driving towards the post. Chris Lyde fires it out to Maloney. Maloney with the runners, but Larder with support from Greenwood. And now Greenwood's given the ball to run back on the inside, turning the defence inside out. Has the pace on the outside. Greenwood looking for a double. Stokes has pace, but he won't get to him. Greenwood will get the ball down. Well, Dave Larder made Lee Greenwood do a bit of extra work there. He had to come inside. He was trying to draw the defence to him was Larder. A bit non-committed, and when they did, Greenwood was on his way back on the inside and then went back out towards the touchline. Farrell's despairing dive got nowhere near. Stokes as a former winger chased down Greenwood. By the time he'd got to him, Greenwood had to slide over the line, put the ball down. A double for the winger. A third try for Halifax, and a lead of Halifax 14, Batley Bulldogs 0. And Greenwood leaving Holroyd. Another kick close to that far touch line. Well, has had one practice as he found the marker this time. Again, it's sailed across the front of the post. It stays at 14 points to nil. Aaron Trinder on for Paul Southern. Harry Thornton also making changes as Maloney goes for the short kick. Haley picks it up off the ground. Chase from Patterson and Tui. Trinder charges the ball up and he's still going forward despite the attention of three defenders. And now Frank Wattini drives the ball up. Well, Trinder and Wattini running the ball up will take a bit out of the Batley defence, but they're not keen to get up and let Halifax have the quick play of the ball. Holroyd pops it up for Royston, and Royston takes a clatter in. Larder to Varkoulis, and again Varkoulis struggling against the defence. Langley the first man in. But reinforcements there quickly. Penkovic off the side of the foot, looking to put the ball behind the Batley line again. And Batley will be forced once again to drop out. That's the third time. Seems to be becoming quite a trademark for Halifax. Forcing the opposition to drop out from behind the post, beneath the post. So So Maloney's kick will reach Penkovic just inside halfway, and Trinder will take it back 20 metres, and Martini will look to do the same. And almost does as well. He's made another probably 12 or 13. Sam Hoare feeds Holroyd back on the inside. Is Royston, and Royston almost through. Again, the tackle looked to be around the neck. Penkovic turned it inside to Damien Ball, but Ball has nowhere to go. Defence on him as soon as he took the ball. Sam Hoare has Wattini running. Reached out but couldn't get to the line. Last tackle. Damien Ball fires it away to Holroyd, and Holroyd, an uncharacteristic mistake. Maloney flew out of the blocks there, and he's quick to try and get the ball back into play. But Gareth Hugh are waiting while Halifax are back onside for allowing the play to continue. Approaching the half hour mark, 14 points to nil. Not as easy as it was against Lee last week. But the defensive effort is probably as much as Martin Hall could expect. Batley, very few visits into the Halifax half of the field. I think it's only the third of the first half. But forcing the dropout, making the tackles. Toohey kicks for Marnes to chase, and Royston will pick it up. And Marnes is left with nothing as Royston cuts loose with a ball back on the counter-attack. Gets over the 20-metre line, and there's a quick play as well. Penkovic slips one tackle, gets to 5 metres from halfway. Frank Wattini taking the ball from a standing start, takes it over halfway into a three-man tackle. Damien Ball moves into acting half as Holroyd puts Greenwood on a chase again. Lindsay will go back, and Lindsay is going to be caught behind his line again, and Halifax will produce another great run, which will mean Batley dropping out from under the post for the fourth time. Lindsay doing his best to get out of trouble, but
number 14, Ian Watson, for number 9, Sam Hoare.
He was never going to get the ball back into the field of play. Gareth Hewer speaking with his touch judge. And Ollie Marnes being pulled out by the referee, I think, for the attempted trip on Shad Royston at the other end of the field.
Well, we'd sort of made a 30-yard break, didn't we, from it, so we needed a quick play of
the ball. So Marnes warned for the attempted trip on Royston, who will be underneath the kick and give it to Trinder. Trinder charges a ball back up into the Batley defence, stopped by three. Wattini over the 20. Halifax looking for 4 points before the half time break. Watson, who replaced Sam Hoare, will get clattered. What a good tackle from Tim Spears and Lee Patterson. Trinder throws the dummy 5 metres away. Penkovic to Watson. Watson goes again on his own. Tries to get the arm free. Last tackle. Penkovic buries his way through, but will he get the ball down? No, the Batley defence forcing back. Well, the pressure not off, because Batley once again will have to run the ball away from their own line. And Marnes caught by Watson and Gibson trying the outside line. Patterson from acting half. Damien Ball leaves the field to be replaced by Mark Roberts, who'll get one of his rare games in the second row by the look of it. Gibson covering the ball, Royston picks it up. Wanted Gibson to have a run, and Gibson said, "You'll go on your own. I've just run all the way back to the ball," and Royston goes in field. Haley stopped, ball comes loose. Referee at the touchdown to the other side said it was a knock on. And touching on the far side, looking a bit stunned there when the when Gareth Hewer asked him what had happened. Maloney caught by Royston. Now it's Batley's turn to look for points before the half-time break. Man's almost getting through. Smith and Royston doing the tackling. Jack Watson stopped 3 metres away. Maloney has runners, but the door shut on Tommy Gallagher by Wattini and Penkovic. Chances now, but again Thewlis this time snubbed out on the last tackle. It'll go back to Maloney for the kick, and Maloney has got a better kick in this time, but Gibson the first to it. Well, Halifax supporters not agreeing. They think Gibson was in the field of play when he took the ball, but he finished up behind the line. And there may have been a case for being making the attempt to tackle in the air there, I'm not so sure. Hall rides a long kick, Marnes underneath, gives it inside to Watson. And Watson takes it to the 14 to the tackle of Roberts and Smith. Chris Lyde feeds Thewlis. Frank Wattini and Trinder stopping the progress of the Batley replacement. So we're on the run round with Spears, turning back inside Lyde. Out to the right-hand side, Patterson will find Maloney, and Maloney will lose possession in trying to keep the ball alive as Larder then loses possession. It's picked up by Stokes, and a chance for Batley to attack the line, but Lindsay wriggling out of the first two tackles, taking the ball back to within 5 metres, and that play, the ball looked to be far too quick, but it's paid dividends, and Chris Langley has gone in at the corner for Batley's first try on around 35 minutes. Well, Halifax were on the breakaway. Larder was looking for support. There was nobody there. And he didn't have hold of the ball tightly enough. It came loose. Batley went on the counter-attack with Stokes. And Langley strolled over in the corner. Most Halifax side had stopped expecting something from the referee. Batley played to the whistle. They've got the first 4 points. It's Halifax 14, Batley Bulldogs 4. And Maloney's kick rattles back off the post, much to the joy of the Halifax supporters.
High score for Batley, number 15, Chris Langley.
So Batley back in the match. More by luck than management, anyway, that's for sure. Halifax had done the tackling, dislodged the possession, and Batley managed to get it back. Good tackle from Watson, quickly followed up by Smith on the Batley 20. And Roberts, it is again with Smith halting that run after about 3 metres. Blythe feeds it to Jack Watson. Tree slide back to Maloney, who will try and successfully get a 40-20. Greenwood saw what was happening but was too slow to react to get back for the kick. It was a huge kick by Maloney. And this has given the Bulldogs a glorious opportunity before half-time to pull themselves right back into this game. Two-way. Sets the ball on his own. And Royston around the legs, claiming the penalty. Maloney, the old stager, going for the try. And he's not that far off neither. He just stops out of the line by the Halifax defence. Stokes fires the pass away. Lythe takes it on the bounce. And then falls to the tackle of Penkovic. All hands to the pump for Halifax as... Oh, that must have been a yard forward. Oh, dearie me, he's not seen that one. And Halifax almost getting caught from acting half there. The gap that was there, but Lythe just couldn't get through it. Now back to Maloney. Is this another kick? It is. And Gibson is behind his own line this time. A wrestling with Marnes. Halifax looking for the quick play with Penkovic. Gibson wanted to get into the action and get back to the play of the ball, but Penkovic took it on his own and made 10. Paul Smith will make another 10. Watson to Robert. Stopped by Farrell. Trinder to Watine. Halifax just getting over the fortet. Larder taken by Chris Lyde on the last tackle, 22 metres out. Back to Watson. And that one has put Marnes under all sorts of pressure. But Batley come up with the possession with Patterson. Now Marnes invited to run the ball out. To the significant frame of Watine. Stokes trying to help out the forwards, takes the ball up to the 20. And Batley lose it in an effort to keep it alive. Varkoulis for once slips the net of the first tackle and the second. But then he's stopped by Tui. And Tim Spears. Watine gets it to Penkovic and Penkovic stuck then because Royston almost fell over him. Lindsay tries to go around the outside, but Greenwood wraps him up after Larder missed him at the first attempt. Batley back up to the 40, looking for the quick play of the ball. The quick play of the ball takes him up to halfway. Spears takes it over the 40. Patterson gets it away to Stokes, and Stokes has support from Maloney, and Maloney's away from three. Unfortunately, the pass bounced off the head of the hooker Chris Lizer, went forward. Halifax were looking frail then. It was Maloney, the old campaigner, who cut the Halifax defence apart. The final pass letting him down. The ball bouncing forward off the head of the hooker. Roberts comes up from loose forward. Haley taking the ball up. Shouts that the Batley players are in an offside position. They're certainly struggling to make it square at the play of the ball. Watine takes the pass off Penkovic. Looked as though I was expecting Penkovic to go for the return then, but the pass didn't come Penkovic puts it off the outside of his boot, and Greenwood could benefit from this, but Penkovic has made the support, and Varkoulis for the first time in the match without a marker and without anybody watching him closely, Varkoulis strides over. Greenwood somehow managing to get the ball back. Penkovic looked like he might have scored, but the Batley defence scrambling, and the scrum half feeds Varkoulis, who for once was unmarked, and it went over for the fourth try of the first half. Going to try to settle the nerves a little bit. Halifax 18, Batley Bulldogs 4. And the last action of this first half will be Holroyd's kick.
TV match on Friday, I noticed. Somebody's having a try right on time like that.
And it's another attempt from Holroyd from far out of the other side of the field. Well, it's getting closer. It comes back off the post. And it's time for half time with Halifax. Not as spectacular as they were last week, but conditions proving a little bit difficult, and Halifax losing possession on several occasions. But four tries from Gibson, two from Greenwood, one from Barkoulis. Just the one conversion from Graham Holroyd against the try for Langley for Batley, which was a touch fortuitous after the possession was lost in the middle of the field. Half-time score, Halifax 18, Batley Bulldogs 4. Dragging himself forward towards that 40-metre line. And as Chris Lythe all over him. Sam Hoare to Penkovic. Penkovic looked for support. That's the third one that's gone to ground off Penkovic. Only played in glorious conditions last week, but with a slippy ball and a slippy ground, it's not an afternoon for the fancy stuff. And another Penkovic pass goes to ground.
Substitution for Halifax.
Halifax will be tested in defence again.
Number 17, Frank Wattini, for number 10, Dave Wrench.
Frank Wattini on for Dave Wrench, and Aaron Trinder soon to be introduced as well as he waits his turn to come on. Tui gets the ball away. Halifax are offside, says the referee. Andy Jarrett driving towards the post. Chris Lythe fires it out to Maloney. Maloney with the runners, but Larder with support from Greenwood. And now Greenwood's given the ball to run back on the inside, turning the defence inside out. Has the pace on the outside. Greenwood looking for a double. Stokes has pace, but he won't get to him. Greenwood will get the ball down. Well, Dave Larder made Lee Greenwood do a bit of extra work there. He had to come inside. He was trying to draw the defence to him was Larder. A bit non-committed, and when they did, Greenwood was on his way back on the inside and then went back out towards the touchline. Farrell's despairing dive got nowhere near. Stokes is a former winger, chased down Greenwood. By the time he'd got to him, Greenwood had to slide over the line, put the ball down. A double for the winger. A third try for Halifax, and a lead of Halifax 14, Batley Bulldogs 0. And Greenwood leaving Holroyd. Another kick close to that far touch line. Well, has had one practice as he found the marker this time. Again, it's sailed across the front of the post. It stays at 14 points to nil. Aaron Trinder on for Paul Southern. Harry Thornton also making changes as Maloney goes for the short kick. Haley picks it up off the ground. Chase from Patterson and Tuwe. Trinder charges the ball up and he's still going forward despite the attention of three defenders. And now Frank Wattini drives the ball up. Well, Trinder and Wattini running the ball up will take a bit out of the Batley defence, but they're not keen to get up and let Halifax have the quick play of the ball. Holroyd pops it up for Royston, and Royston takes a clatter in. Larder to Varkoulis, and again Varkoulis struggling against the defence. Langley the first man in. But reinforcements there quickly. Penkovic off the side of the foot, looking to put the ball behind the Batley line again. And Batley will be forced once again to drop out. That's the third time. Seems to be becoming quite a trademark for Halifax. Forcing the opposition to drop out from behind the post, beneath the post. So Maloney's kick will reach Penkovic just